Honestly, China is one of my favorite places to travel. It's one of the most unique landscapes in the world, that's for sure. Just these vegetation-covered, crazy dots on the landscape in every direction. It just goes forever.
We're nearby. This little guy.
Oh, so you're like way back there.
Really? Yeah,
so it'd be like we were.
We're here with the climbing community, and we're meeting these amazing people, and we all share the same passion. And the climbing is just good. It's just like awesome.
Dude, this is gonna work.
That's gonna be comfy, actually.
It's just a three-hour drive. This is totally chill. This is the kind of situation where if you stick your head out the window too far, you might actually get decapitated. We're en route to get to, and this is part of China I've never seen. Really excited. Wow, that is just, what is that? Packed our 25 bags into this little car, and now we're cruising across Southeast China. Okay, I got it. Tara, you can. Probably don't need to film. I got it.
The first stop is Getu, which is more or less the middle of nowhere in China. This is a time of immense development in this part of China, and right now they're building this enormous park, basically, for tourists to visit the Getu Arch. It's kind of the total package for traveling as a climber, I think, because you're actually going to an area with really good rock climbing, and yet you have the sensational experience that is China.
Don't know exactly what to expect yet, but we're up, man, so we're going, you know what I mean?
We're on our way into the Great Arch now this morning, and the most spectacular thing probably I've ever seen is happening. Early in the morning, the sun comes through the backside of the Great Arch, and never seen anything like it, that's for sure. Talking about some noodles we ate this morning, which may or may not have been a good idea. It's a Mao, like a metric ton of noodles and spicy chilies and stuff before we go try and siege the wall. But Greg and I will find out shortly.
Greg is an incredible climber, really funny guy.
Need any water?
Yeah.
I was psyched to have him as a partner in the arch.
Just walked up about 877 stairs or so. My legs are a little jelly, but it's good. Good warm up.
I think we're gonna climb the mountain. I mean, we kind of have to, because there's no other way to get down. Right. So the only way to get down is from the summit.
Every pitch kind of has a bit of a different character. The first pitch is more near vertical. It's got some tufas, some edging, stuff like that. And then as you move into the roof of the arch, it changes. It's dynamic, it's everything you would expect from a 200 meter cave route.
We're on a bullet train between Guiyang and Guilin, and we just finished climbing in Getu for 4 days, 4 days of climbing, and now we're heading to Yangshuo.
Yangshuo is famous for rock climbing, and a lot of climbers come from everywhere.
You could say that people know about this place.
She does this every day, so she's five.
part of the reason why Yangshuo is such a tourist destination for Chinese and foreigners alike is the landscape.
Chill with that pano.
I mean, just to be here and observe this place is incredible.
We're here at the view spot. Maybe you didn't pick the best day, but it's still really pretty, and it's just cool to leave town and come up into these little farming zones.
A huge part of what makes Yangshuo such an amazing destination for climbing is there's a plethora of crags all within a really small area.
So we're here now at Moon Hill, just outside of Yangshuo, and it only opens for a few days of the year, so it's really popular when it does, and we got super lucky to be here just in time. Well, I just came down for the first time from the spicy dumpling. It's super cool, very bouldery, but mostly it's just really dirty.
White Mountain is the crown jewel of Yangshuo, and furthermore, it's probably the best single cliff for sport climbing in all of Asia. 90% of my psych was to try and climb spicy dumpling.
Like, it says 0 millimeters on Monday, but then if you go to the daily for Monday, it says 30 millimeters.
We're kind of battling a bit with the weather, like rain versus sun, a little hot, a little wet. Yesterday I one-hung the route, so that was good. Pretty confident, I just need to get the right weather window and be rested and stuff, so.
Spicy Dumpling is a route that Chris Sharma bolted many years ago, and Ethan Pringle did the first ascent of. It climbs up this awesome white panel to a very hard boulder problem. And then afterwards goes up this awesome little tufa in this dark black rock, basically all the way to the summit of the route.
Super psyched to have it done, and now I have a couple days to do something else fun too, hopefully.
I'm really grateful on how we have been received by the community here. They've been incredibly welcoming.
That's the finger stamp you get from a climbing 515.
They just want to share in this place and in success and the food and everything. And they're so psyched we're coming here, and even psyched that we're drawing attention to this place that they love. It's a good vibe to be around.